Bonjour et bienvenue to French class. This is Shalaka from Empower Tutorial. So friends, we all know that COVID-19 pandemic is increasing a lot these days. Okay, so we hope that you all are safe at home and maintaining all the precautions against COVID-19. So please be at home and watch our videos. So today we are going to discuss interrogative, how to form the question, inversion, third type inversion. So please watch my first video before this, because in that video I have discussed about esque and antonacia. Okay, so friends, I'm sharing you the screen now. So inversion, what is inversion? Okay, so here in inversion, what we have, we are doing it inverse. Inverse means what? We are inversing the verb and the pronunciation. Yeah, friends, 1 minute, there is a problem. I'm sharing you the screen again. Yeah, 1 minute. Yeah, so that is inverse. Okay, now we have already discussed about antonacio and esque, right? So in antonacio, what we do, we put the order of the sentence same. Okay, now the inversion, see, in each sentence we have two parts. One is pronunciation and second is verb and the noun. So here what we are doing, while forming the question, we are inversing, we are putting the verb before the pronunciation, subject pronoun. Okay, now let's see the example. For example, you speak French. Okay, it means tu parles français. Okay, now tell me, which is the subject pronoun here? Yes, tu. And which is the verb here? Parle. Yes. So here, if I want to ask the question, I'm inversing. I'm putting the parle before tu. So parle tu français. And there's a hyphen between parle and tu. Do you speak French? Okay. Now look at the second example. See. If it is a formal case, we can use vous also. In French, we have tu and vous, right? Please watch my video subject pronoun for this. Tu means informal, vous means formal. If it is formal, then parlez-vous. If it is informal, then parle-tu. Okay? The translation in French will remain same. Okay? Now the second example. Il parle français. Again, we have il as a subject pronoun, parle as a verb. So inverse it, parle-t-il français with hyphen. So here, parle is ending with T consonant and il is starting with vowel. So there is a liaison and pronunciation is parle-t-il. Parle-t-il français and question mark. Do they speak French? Okay. Now, next, tu aimes de la musique. Tu aimes de la musique. You like the music. Now use the inversion. So you tell me, which is the pronunciation here? Tu, correct. And which is the verb here? Aime. Yes. So do the inversion. Yes. Aime tu de la musique. Aime tu with hyphen. De la musique. Do you like the music? This is inversion. Okay. Now next. See, elle a un portable. Elle a un portable. She has a mobile. Now here, tell me, which is the verb here? A, correct. A is the verb. Of what? So according to the rule, if we do the inversion, like a elle un portable? A elle un portable means does she have a mobile? No, this is wrong. Because, see, in French, if we have two vowels, we put something between it. So we are putting T here. We put T here. Because we don't write two vowels together, one after another. Okay? And when we read it, a elle un portable, it is not sounding good. Okay? So we are using T. So what is the rule when we have two vowels, like I is a vowel, A is starting with the vowel E. So we have two hyphens here, A hyphen T hyphen L, Atel. The pronunciation is Atel. Atel un portable, does she have a mobile? Okay, now next one. Il écoute la radio. Il écoute la radio. He listens a radio. Okay. Now here, sentence is starting with il, pronoun subject. Okay. So again, écoute is ending with vowel. So two vowels. So we are putting T. Écoute la radio. Écoute la radio. Does he listen a radio? Okay. Next. Il finit son travail. Il finit son travail. So just now, last two examples we learned when there is the il el conjugation, we put T, right? So if you do the same thing here, finit il la radio, then it will be wrong. Why? Because fini is not ending with the vowel. It is ending with T. Okay? And we have already T there. Means it is not vowel consonant. So no need of putting an extra T here. So we are doing a, we are doing only inversion. So fini til la radio. Fini til son travail. Not radio, there is a mistake. Fini til son travail. Okay? Now, next. Elle attend pour moi. Elle attend pour moi. See here. Now you tell me. Attend. Attend is ending with vowel or consonant. D. D is a consonant. But L is starting with vowel. Okay. So if we write attendel pour moi, then whether it is correct or wrong? Wrong, yes. So the inversion is attend elle pour moi. Attend elle pour moi. Does she wait for me? Okay. Attend elle pour moi. Now next. Elle va au restaurant. She goes to restaurant. Elle va au restaurant. Okay, now tell me the inversion. Yes. Va-t-elle au restaurant? Va-t-elle au restaurant? Does she go to restaurant? Yes. Now, next example. Yes, this is a little bit complex. Okay. Il y a les meubles dans la maison. Il y a means there is, there are. So there are furniture in the house. Il y a les meubles dans la maison. Okay. Now tell me, which is the subject pronoun here? Yes, il. And which is the verb here? A. Okay. So we are using the same method of inversion, but in this case, we are starting with the Y. Okay. So Y, then A, then hyphen, then T, then hyphen il. See here, A is a vowel, il, I is a vowel, so we are using til, T here, atil. So atil is same according to the rule. Just we are starting the sentence with Y. But don't put the hyphen between Y and A. There is a little bit gap. So Y space a space, t space, it. Y a-t-il meubles dans la maison? Y a-t-il les meubles dans la maison? Are there furniture in the house? Yes. Okay. Now next, same. The sentence is starting with il y a. Il y a un cahier sur la table. Il y a un cahier sur la table. There is notebook on the table. There is notebook on the table. So now inversion. Yatil. Starting with one. Yatil un cahier sur la table. Yatil un cahier sur la table. Question mark. Is there a notebook on the table? Okay. Same. Next. Just me fourth. I am strong. Okay. So, inversion. Suis-je fort? Am I strong? Suis-je fort? Yes. J'ai trois chats. J'ai trois chats. I have three cats. Again, I am doing inversion because we have avoir here. So, ai-je trois chats? Ai-je trois chats? Have I got three cats? So, here, listen carefully. In a job, we are using only for être and avoir verb. Okay? We are not using the je, inversion of je for any other verbs like parler, me, another thing. Only two verbs, être and avoir. Okay? See, for example, je parle français. I speak French. Je parle français. I speak French. If I want to ask the question, do I speak French? I'm not using here inversion because we don't have here être or avoir. We are having the verb parler. So what am I going to do? Yes, I'm going to use est-ce. Est-ce que je parle français? Est-ce que je parle français? Question mark. Okay. Second, je joue au tennis. I play tennis. So which is the verb here? Joue. Neither être nor avoir. Joue. So what is the inversion? If I want to ask, do I play tennis? Est-ce que je joue au tennis? Est-ce que je joue au tennis? Okay. Now there is a quiz. Elle est belle. She is beautiful. So tell me the inversion. Yes, correct. Est-elle belle? Est-elle belle? Is she beautiful? Next, vous êtes français. You are French. Vous êtes français. What is the inversion? Mm-hmm. Very good. Êtes-vous français? Are you French? Êtes-vous français? With hyphen. Okay. Next. Nous faisons notre travail. Nous faisons notre travail. We are doing our work. Now tell me the inversion here. Faisons-nous notre travail? Very simple. Faisons-nous notre travail. Are we doing our work? Yes. Now, using Ilia. Ilia des étudiants dans l'école. Il y a des étudiants dans l'école. There are students in the school. Now, tell me the answer. Yes. Y a-t-il des étudiants dans l'école? Are there students in the school? Y a-t-il. Okay. See, in interrogative, we have three types. These types means when we form the question using these types, the answer should be yes or no. For example, Yatil des étudiants dans l'école? Yes or no. Then, faisons-nous notre travail? Yes or no. Or, est-ce que tu manges? Yes. Do you eat? Yes or no. Okay. So, when we use these three forms, the answer should be yes or no. So, Antonacio, Roman 1. Esco, comma, Roman 2, and inversion, Roman 3. So in exam, when you have this type of question, you have Roman 1, Roman 2, Roman 3. And they write like this. Il dance dans la soirée. He dance in the party. So here we have Roman 2. So what is Roman 2? Esco. So you have to form the question using esco. Like, Esquil dance dans la soirée. Esquil dance dans la soirée. Yes? Now the second. Does he dance in the party? Vous chantez bien. Vous chantez bien. Means you sing well. Yes, you sing well. So here we have Roman 2. So what is in the Roman 2? Antonacio. So form the question using antonacio. Vous chantez bien? It's only you have to, when you have to write the same tense sentence and question mark. Orally we say, vous chantez bien? And question mark. Okay? Now, third, ils sont informaticiens. They are software engineers. So here we have Roman 3. So what is mean by Roman 3? Inversion. Yes. So use inversion here. Sont-ils informaticiens? Are they computer engineers? Yes. Next. Nous choisissons des rôles. We choose phrases. Again, we have Roman 3 here. So what we are going to do is inversion. So, choisissons-nous des robes? Yes. Do we choose dresses? Il regarde la télévision. We have Roman 1 here. He watches TV. So Roman 1 means what? Yes. Antonacio, correct. So use antonacio here. Il regarde la télévision. Yes. So in this session, we discuss inversion. Okay. Inversion means what? We are inversing the verb and the subject pronoun. Okay. First rule. Then second rule, if there is a il, okay, singular, and the verb is also ending with the vowel and the subject pronoun is starting with the vowel, we use T. Okay, écoutel, partil, okay. But if we have verb for like fini, F-I-N-I-T, it's not ending with the vowel. So no need of using T. So in interrogative, we have three types, antonacio, esco, and inversion. So to revise the interrogative, please watch the earlier video and this video. And then you can solve the exercise of interrogative. Roman 1, Roman 2, and Roman 3. Okay. So friends, don't take any tension. Be at your home. Please follow all the guidelines of COVID-19 and please watch our videos. If you like this video, please subscribe, empower, and please click on your bell icon. Yes. Thank you for watching this video. Au revoir.